Hi, I'm going to show you how to navigate the PM eCollection bookshelf as a student. What you need to do is go to your web browser, or if you're using an iPad or tablet, select the app PM eCollection. On the web browser, you'll need to type in app.pmecollection.com.au. It'll bring you to this site here, where we have two buttons available. Go ahead and click login. You'll need to enter in your username and password. Please be aware that these are cap sensitive as well as space sensitive. It has now brought me to the PM eCollection bookshelf for Theo. What Theo currently has is access to levels 1 all the way through down to level 30 readers. Every book in that range. As the teacher, you are able to minimize the range that the student is able to see through their student profile. We're going to go ahead and select one of the books and show you the features of them. So we'll select Jolly Roger the Pirate. First thing that'll come up is the front page, and then we can look at the back page, or back cover, I should say. Next thing we want to do is read the book. So we're going to open it, and now we can read along. Using your mouse, scroll to the right-hand side of screen, and there'll be the arrow, which you can click to go to the next page. On the iPads, it'll be using your finger gesture, swiping from right to left. The next feature is listening to individual words being read on the page. To do this, using your mouse and the left click, click on an individual word.
Jolly.
It'll highlight and read it out to the student. On an iPad, you use your fingertip and tap on the word individually. The next feature is reading out a whole page to a student. To do that on the web browser, there'll be the play button on the side here, and the students can click the button.
Jolly Roger woke up.
Listen to the whole page.
Where are my big boots? He said.
To access this feature on the iPads and tablets, the student will need to, using their fingertip again, swipe from top to bottom of the screen. The next feature is saving words to a student's word bank. To do this, they'll need to go over the top of a word and with their mouse, right-click the word, and the word will appear with a clipboard and a plus sign. I'm going to click on the clipboard, and that'll be saved to that student's word bank. On an iPad or tablet, the feature is with your finger swiping across the word, and again, the same options will appear with the clipboard. The next thing we're going to look at is our home button. As you can see, there are 5 different buttons to select from. Home will take us back to our bookshelf. Recording, students are able to record themselves reading the book. Editing, they can edit pages and change words around under the supervision of teachers, and also drawing under the supervision of teachers. In the record section, there are 2 buttons to select from: play, which will play the word out for them, and generally used before the students recorded so they know what they need to say. Then you have the microphone button, which when the student selects it, they will then be able to record themselves reading out the whole page, and then stop recording. Please be aware that if this is not available, you may need to check your settings, such as up the top here, it allows for the microphone to be accessed on this computer in this browser. And then you can move on to the next page and have it recorded. It does only allow you to record one page at a time. Then we have the edit button. And like I said, you can add additional words, you can change sentences. This feature here was designed as a in-classroom activity under the supervision of teachers, and it will not be saved to the student's profile or sent anywhere. So once taken out of this screen, it will be deleted. Same thing for the draw function. You can circle, you can draw. But once we go out of this screen, it does remove it. The next button is the independent reading button. Once selected, it gives you three different profiles to select from. Independent reading profile. What this allows is for recordings to be done, listening of individual words, and listening of whole pages. Guided reading profile is designed for a guided reading session with teacher supervision or teachers listening in on the students, and removes the feature of recording and listening to words and sentences being read out to you. There's also custom reading profile, which has the ability to remove certain features within the book as well. For the purpose of our exercise, we're going to leave it on independent reading profile. So now those are the main features of inside the PME collection reading the books. We're going to go home and we're going to go select up the top my words. And these are the words that have been saved to that student's word bank over the course of their reading history. They can select individual words, hear that word being read out to them, hear it in a sentence, and then they can also delete it if they feel comfortable that they've been able to successfully read it out. Teachers have access to these words and they can also delete it from the teacher's dashboard. You will notice also this box of books up the top here. This is a session that's been created for the student and would have been done in the session section of the teacher's dashboard eCollection. So what we'll do is this session has been created for the student and a note has been sent home to the student. Book for the weekdays. Make sure you read this book over the weekend. Record yourself reading two pages and save one word that was difficult or hard for you. What animals can you see in your garden? So certain activities that we've requested the student to do. So what we then can do is go in and select a particular book we want them to read. And again, it brings up the book itself, click read, and they'll be able to use the additional features that we just covered. You're able to search for titles as well within the range that's available for the student to be seen. And then there's also a help button, which takes you to the Cengage website and shows you certain piece of information, such as how to navigate the bookshelf and accessing the subscription, as well as troubleshoot issues that you may need. And that is using the PME Collection bookshelf. Thank you.